Hey there, scientists, it's Justin again. Have you ever seen a magician pull a rabbit out of a hat? Well, today I'm going to do something even more spectacular. I am going to pull something out of this hat without even touching it. I know. And the best part is, it's not even magic. It's science. Watch this. Ta-da! Pretty impressive, huh? I used this magnet to pull this paperclip out of the hat without touching it. I know it's not really magic, but I can't quite explain how the magnet was able to do that. You know, why do things stick to magnets? We know that objects can't move unless a force is acting on them. This ball won't move unless I throw it. My jacket zipper won't zip unless I pull it. So if the magnet wasn't touching the paperclip, how did it make the paperclip move? Well, magnets have the very special ability to apply force without touching an object. It seems like magic, but remember, it's just science. Magnets have their own force called magnetism that pushes and pulls certain objects. Let me show you. Here I have the same paperclip and magnet from my magic trick. When I bring the magnet closer, the magnet pulls the paperclip towards it. How cool is that? It's using magnetism to pull the paperclip closer. I have an idea. Let's see what happens when we put two magnets together. Magnets have two different sides called poles. They have a north pole and a south pole. If you look at the ends of a magnet, you'll see a red side with an N and a blue side with an S. The N stands for north and the S stands for south. That's how you can tell which pole is which. When I bring the north pole to the south pole, they attract each other or pull, just like the paperclip. But when I bring the matching poles together, they repel each other or push each other away. Wow, magnetism is amazing. Did you know that only some things are magnetic? That means attracted to magnets. Why don't we, perfect. My backpack's right here. Let me grab some items so we can test. Okay, I found a safety pin, a pencil, and scissors. Let's test these objects and see if they're magnetic or not. Make sure you have your magnetism investigation sheet and a pencil ready to go. The first object we're going to test is this safety pin. Before we test it, we need to make a prediction on our magnetism investigation sheet. Color in the thumbs up if you think it will be attracted to the magnet, or color in the thumbs down if you do not think it will be attracted to the magnet. All right, here we go. Look at that. The safety pin is magnetic. The magnet pulled it up using its force of magnetism. Color in the thumbs up in the next column to show that the safety pin was magnetic. Let's make a prediction about our next object, a pencil. Thumbs up if you think the pencil is magnetic, and thumbs down if you think it is not magnetic. Here we go. Looks like this pencil is not magnetic. The magnet's magnetism did not attract this pencil. And finally, we have scissors. Make your prediction. Will the scissors be magnetic or not? Let's find out. Wow, the scissors are magnetic. But are you noticing what I'm noticing? Only the metal part of the scissors is sticking to the magnet. I wonder if the plastic part of these scissors is magnetic too. Let's find out. Yeah, the plastic is not magnetic, but the metal part is. Remember, magnets have a force called magnetism that attracts only certain objects. As we learned with my scissors and pencil, magnets do not attract wood or plastic, but they do attract metal, like my safety pin and the metal on my scissors. But not all metals are magnetic. The metals that are magnetic are iron, nickel, cobalt, and steel. It's hard to tell if a metal object is magnetic just by looking at it, because different metals can look very similar. If you have a magnet at home, pause the video here and find three more objects to test on your magnetism investigation sheet. I challenge you to find a metal object in your home that is not magnetic. So, how did magnetism help me perform my magic trick? Well, magnets have a force called magnetism. We know that certain metal objects made of iron, nickel, cobalt, or steel are magnetic, which means they are attracted to magnets. That means the paperclip must be made out of one of those metals. Magnetism pulls or attracts magnetic objects towards it, and pushes or repels like poles away from it. Magnets can push and pull magnetic materials without even touching them. Continue investigating magnets to discover as many magnetic objects around your home as you can. Maybe you can even turn your investigation into a magic show. Thanks for joining me today. Remember, science is all around us, and I'll see you next time.